So that became Runa in the form of this mysterious bird, and God actually saved Haga and Ishmael. So that is why you have already seen God is described as an enigmatic God. So whether how God sent this mysterious bird, how God made a fountain formed in this desert, etc., it was very mysterious. Hagar didn't have such an idea, and so that is why the ways of God is also very mysterious. So Hagar became very happy, and he was very humbled by there was a humility there in the mind of this Hagar, and she became very happy, and she settled down there. And now when the people, the tribal people, when they heard about all these things, and they also came there, some primitive people, the tribal people, and they were also suffering due to lack of water. So they heard that there was a spring came in the desert, and also a mother and a son was there, etc. They heard about that. They came to this desert in order to meet this Hagar and the son, and also in order to have some water from this water source. And then what happened, you can see in the coming paragraph. And now they saw the lake, and also beside this lake here, they have already seen a woman and also a baby in her lap. And now the nomads and the tribal people, they were asking whether they also will get some water from this water source. And now she was ready. Now Hagar was agreed. And so there was a water covenant was made in between them. That you have seen in this next paragraph. Because Hagar could understand the thirst of a people, the infinite value of water, and the secret of life scripted in it, that you can understand. So now Hagar already understood how much precious water drops are, or water is, or how water is acting as a preserver of life. She already understood from her own life, because for a few moments ago, she and her son Ishmael, they were about to die. But all of a sudden, due to the appearance of this water source, both of them came back to life. So she understood if there is no water, how human life would be. So she agreed to the request of this nomads and the tribal people. So there is a covenant made in between. So she is giving some advices to them. Water is life itself. And now she is explaining how much important water was for her and for her son, etc. And then when you come to the middle of the paragraph, she is telling, to me, the value of the first drop of water is the value of the life of my soul. That you can underline. And because you have seen, as soon as she saw the water source, she had done, we have already seen. She take the baby in her arms and put her in the pool, in the lake. And so that is why she is telling, the first drop of water was the value of the life of my firstborn. That means, if water was not there, if the first drop of water was not there, my firstborn child may die. He may not be there. And so that is why she is telling, the first drop of water is the life of my firstborn. And so here the nomads and the tribal people are there, and there was a covenant made in between these two. And you have seen water covenant, and that water covenant is very important. And what was the covenant in between there? And also she is explaining, the first drop of water is coolness that flowed into my soul like the assurance of life itself. And also she is telling, not a drop of water shall be wasted. And so she gives a lot of advices to them about how precious water is. Each drop of water is very precious. She is telling by that. So, the covenant, what was the covenant, that you can see in the remaining paragraph. And there the nomads and the tribal people, they agreed to the condition of Hagar. And now they sensed her earnestness, and they were desperate for water, because these nomads and the tribal people, they didn't have any water at all. So they were in a very disappointing condition. And so that they agreed to her condition. And what was the condition that you have seen in the paragraph? And so Hagar will be the caretaker of the spring, and they will gather. These are the nomads and the tribal people. They will prepare food for Hagar and Ishmael. In return, Hagar will give the water. And that was the condition. That was the covenant. Covenant means a condition made between people. So only give us the water we need. And that is what the nomads said. And so when you come to the next paragraph, the nomads fed her and the child. They in turn bathed and ran water to their heart's content. So according to this water covenant, and Ishmael and the Hagar was fed by, that is the food needed for the baby and the mother. It was prepared by the tribal and the nomads, and in return they got enough water from the spring. And then when you come to the last paragraph, we have seen as a result, after a few while, what happened, you have seen, with the plentiful water they started cultivation. They started cultivating the land and vegetables. They started cultivating vegetables near the lake, and also now they started working together. So during that year they got a very happy harvest. So both of them, that is the nomads and tribal people and also Hagar, they became very happy because that year their harvest was very good, because and they got enough water from the water spring. And then they started celebrating this harvest season. There were so many festivals. And towards the end of that paragraph, we have seen the last line. In due course, a people came into being. And that line is very important because, and you know, many human civilization, and that you has a direct relationship with a river. And for example, you know, Egypt, the civilization of Egypt, and it was it is actually directly connected with the river Nile. So many such Indian civilizations are also there in connection with a river. Similarly, beside this lake, a new civilization started. That is Hagar as the caretaker of the spring, and then the nomads and tribal people, they started cultivating the land. So very gradually, after so many years, human civilization started here, like the Egyptian civilization and many other civilizations existing in the world. And so altogether we have seen two basic things from this lesson. One is, as you have seen in the topic, this story is about a woman and also about the importance of water. And each drop of water is very important, or without water we can't live. And there won't be any life at all if there is no water. So how precious water is in our life and in the whole nature, that we have seen in the, that was the main, that is the main point in this lesson. Secondly, we have seen Hagar's endurance and also her generosity, etc. And so a woman's endurance, you know, and how much endurance she had as a woman. And when she was spending her day and night in the wilderness, how much endurance she showed in order to protect the baby, in order to protect herself. And also we have seen her strong optimism in God, and also she had a strong belief in God, and how that belief came to be true, etc. You have seen. And all these things are very important. And three sets of questions given at the end of the lesson, and you have to refer to that. And each question, you have to go in detail and find out the answer from the lesson, so that you will get an idea about it. So it is a very important lesson because there is a biblical allusion, and also so many references are there, and also so many comparisons. And the poetic lines are given in between, and so that is very important. So mainly you have to focus about the character of Hagar and Hagar Meji, and also Abraham. You can see something. Even though Abraham's picture is only given in the beginning of the lesson, Abraham, a few details about Abraham should also, that also is very important. And also you can see something about Ishmael. So basically, the central character is a Hagar. And then, when you come towards the beginning, and there you have seen, from the beginning till the end, some comparisons you have seen. Once again, we can go through all these comparisons. When you come to page number 127, there you have seen the sun is the sun is comparing to a dragon spitting fire, and then secondly you have seen the burning sand is compared to a red hot pan, and that is the second number sun. And when you come to page number 128, there you have seen the sky is compared to a ceiling of a room. Then the wilderness or the desert is compared to a mansion, but here the difference is the mansion usually gives protection and security to people, but here wilderness is a mansion, but it is not giving any protection or care for Adam and Ishmael. And then the next one is the comparison is the whole desert is covered with the darkness, and that was like a blanket, and also it is like a God's mercy. Only because of God's mercy now the sand dunes are very cold now, and that is also you can see in the next page 129. You have seen during the day the sand is compared to coals of fire, and during the night it is compared to ice cubes, shards of ice pieces, because it is very cold. Throughout lines you have seen the motherly care, protection, how much affection she has towards the baby, then the sacrificing mentality, etc. You have seen. And the next, towards the middle of that page, you have seen the sand remained like cinders of fire, coals of fire, which is almost the same. Then in the next paragraph, you have seen the baby's weak sound. It is compared to a bird's weak sound that you have seen. And also you have seen again you have seen the care of this mother at all. And when you come to page number 130, you have seen again the baby's whimpering sound, and it is compared to the tongues of her. It is licking her heart, or whenever she Hagar is listening to the whimpering sound of the baby, she feels that it is actually burning her heart like a tongues of her, that you have seen. And then the poetic lines that you have seen, then her optimism you have seen in the next page 131, in that poetic line. And when you are coming towards the end of that page 131, you have seen the next comparison. The water or the spring coming out all of a sudden from the desert, it is compared to the water coming out from the pierced eyes of a coconut. And that comparison is there. And when you are coming towards the end of that lesson, the water covenant. That water covenant is very important. And that water covenant is made between Hagar and nomads and the Bible people. So you have seen what is the covenant. That is Hagar is the owner of the spring, and then she is the caretaker. And in return, here the nomads and the tribal people, they will prepare food for mother and the son, and in return Hagar will give them enough water for their cultivation, for bathing, for drinking, for preparing food, for cultivation, etc. And so now they agree, and that is the water covenant. And then towards the end of the lesson you have seen a new civilization started beside this lake, as any human civilization started in the ancient time, like Egyptian civilization and all. So water plays a very important role in the human life, even in forming a civilization. So that is very important. So basically you have to understand about biblical reference, about reference, about the mythical reference are given in the second paragraph about the author. That is very important. And when you read the second paragraph only, you will get an idea about the lesson. And the two main themes also the myths existed in the village in Kerala, and also how Sarah Joseph converted the biblical story into this mythological attitude, mythological viewpoint, etc. And all these things you have to read and then find out the answer to the question. So now we are ending our lesson. The next day we will start with the next module, and then we can see once again we will meet together for the next lesson. And now we are ending the